Have you ever wondered if something could ever escape a black hole? Well, one theory states that some particles can. Hi, I'm Katie Summers, and today I'm going to be talking about Hawking radiation. Hawking radiation is a theoretical radiation proposed by Stephen Hawking in 1974. He stated that black holes might not be entirely black, as there should be some thermal radiation steadily emitting from the black hole itself. Basically, he theorized that there are pairs of particles, one being a normal particle and the other being an antiparticle. They suddenly pop into existence for an instant because quantum physics, and almost immediately once again cease to exist. The exception is when these particles pairs are near the event horizon of a black hole. Here, the particles may separate, the antiparticle falling into the black hole and the particle shooting out and being classified as Hawking radiation. These black holes would also be incredibly difficult to detect as they are extremely high in temperature and would evaporate quite quickly. There are some issues with this theory though. Testing to actually detect the radiation isn't currently feasible as it would have to take place at around 10 to the negative 6 degrees Kelvin and it would be blocked by cosmic microwave background radiation. This means that to detect any Hawking radiation, the black hole would have to have a significantly lower mass than we've ever seen before. These black holes would also be incredibly difficult to detect as they are extremely high in temperature and would evaporate quite quickly. You may be wondering, Katie, how can a black hole evaporate? What does that even mean? Well, this leads us directly back to our concept of Hawking radiation. You know those little tiny particle pairs that we discussed earlier that were made of a particle and an antiparticle? When those negatively charged antiparticles fall into that black hole, they actually take away a bit of the mass and energy from that black hole. That means that over extremely long periods of time, the black hole may lose so much mass that it actually just ceases to exist or evaporates. For a black hole of a single solar mass, this process could take 1.5 times 10 to the 66 years. As it gets smaller, it radiates more and more, and in its final stage, it goes out with a bang equivalent to a billion nuclear bombs.
Sounds pretty straightforward, right?
Nope.
Another issue with Hawking radiation involves the information paradox. Basically, it states that information is never lost. An excellent example of this is if you took the Mona Lisa and completely destroyed it, burning it up, tearing it, running it over, and so on. That painting, theoretically, could still somehow be put back together with all of its original components. The ruined painting was still once the Mona Lisa, and therefore should still be able to be turned back into the Mona Lisa. When a black hole shrinks or evaporates due to Hawking radiation, we have no idea where that information is going. It seems to just be lost to the black hole itself, which becomes the black hole information paradox. This means that we know that there is something missing from our knowledge of the universe that could help us better understand black holes, but we just haven't made that discovery yet. In conclusion, Hawking radiation is an incredible theory, but it's currently just a theory. There's still so much we have to learn before we completely understand not only Hawking radiation, but about black holes themselves. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed.